Greetings, this is Father Rolf Hammerling from Dorsten, Germany. Today is October the 12th, 2023. And the topic of this video is FOV Slider, changing the field of view in games with the examples of Quake using JoeQuake, Doom using PR Boom Plus, and Gothic using the Direct3D 11 renderer. 3 days ago, there was an article on WCCF Tech. Starfield update adds much demanded FOV sliders. Since launching last month, one of the most often cited irritations with Starfield was the inability to adjust your field of view, something considered a must for first-person games these days. Mods have been released that allow players to alter their field of view, but it is something that really should be a standard option nowadays. So what is field of view? There's an article on PC Gaming Wiki, field of view, and we read, field of view, FOV is the amount of game view that is on display during the game, and FOV options are crucial for using ultra-wide screen or multi-monitor resolutions in games. As explained, what's FOV, understanding FOV, geometry distortions, and there's also a video explanation of the problem. And this is this video, and it seems a bit theoretical to me and not exactly suitable to understand the exact impact of FOV in games. So I wanted to see it for myself in a game, and you can do it this way using the Quake shareware and a source port of Quake to use it on modern computers, and with an FOV slider. JoeQuake has an FOV slider integrated. This is JoeQuake with the standard FOV of 90. So you can change it to other values, and if you increase the gamma, you can see it directly. The article of PC Gaming Wiki recommends a field of view of 110. This is 110. But if you increase it more to, say, 130, it looks a bit distorted to me. Maybe a matter of taste, but for me not recommendable. Next example is Doom. There are also some swap sports, and I use PR Boom Plus. PR Boom Plus does not have a slider in its strict sense, but you can change the value for field of view manually from 20 to 180. Now this is 20. A bit difficult to see everything. No. 60, was it? Yes, we're talking about 60. Yes. Still not totally convincing for me. And again, I would recommend a value of 110. Okay, you can play around this with these options to get an impression what FOV does and how useful a FOV slider in game is. And now a game that is not shareware, but very interesting because it is a third-person view. This game is Gothic, and someone wrote a mod using the Direct 3D 11 renderer, and in this, it's a bit dark, but this is the original view from the game, and with the mouse wheel you can change the camera distance up to this point. And with this Direct 3D renderer, you can change the FOV, enable FOV override, and then it could look this. This is FOV override enabled. This is the maximum of 150. You can change vertical FOV and horizontal FOV independently. Very interesting. And with FOV override disabled, this one. Okay, that's it. You have some impression how FOV can change the vision, the view for your personal experience of a game. And indeed, I agree, this is an option that should have been integrated by the developers of games directly and not by any modders. I appreciate that modders do this work for the developers, but indeed it's crucial to give you the option to change the FOV yourself.